books or something random. I'll just open it and some of my people will like that. And I'll just say it in an American accent. Oh, no, hang on, my life. Hello, everybody. Welcome to today's lesson. Music, yeah, why not? Music. Interactive software. PC. 538-687. Can we all say that together?
538-687.
Lovely. We kind of know that bit by now. Hopefully you were all logged in, etc, etc. This is our music lesson. We're going to start with a piece of music to listen to. It's a belter, I'm being brutally honest. It's on the BBC 10 Pieces website if you want to have a look. In fact, no, we're not going to do that. I'm going to start with our quiz so that Evie doesn't miss out. This is your quiz from last week. See what you've remembered. I'll just check actually anyone can hear me. Could I actually turn the microphone up? Oh, yeah. It's going better today. Let's start with our quiz. Get everyone warmed up to start with. Excellent. Thank you, Mrs. Wilde. Thumbs up from next door. See what you remembered from the last week. Things are nine. I'm going to stop our music today because I'm going to play something slightly different. This is a piece we're going to be listening to start off with. Quite quiet piece-ish. Friendly. As you're playing, take a little listen to this piece. Business end of these lessons now. time that better, couldn't it? Someone's going to get there. It's Chris Critters. Who's coming second? It's no pros, and our third place today is... It's the Lava Slingers. Well, that took a bit of doing today, clearly. I think we forgot them more than we remembered. See how well we've done. So, most people get a piccolo of a highest instrument. Ooh, we did much better with this one. Pizzicato, I mean plucked, remember? Forte, brilliant answer there. Most people getting that one right. String instruments, smallest string instrument for violin, viola next big. Sitar is a string instrument, but it's not the smallest, it's not used in the orchestra. Woodwind sounds like a duck. Most people get mission right, the oboe. Triangle doesn't sound much like a duck, it sounds like a, well, a triangle. Which of these does not use strings? The flute, well done. Brass instrument, trombone with a slide. I already spot the trombonist in the playground. Can't swing, doesn't know how to use the slide. Which word means slow? Largo. A lot of people are saying presto again. Remember, presto is quite a quick sounding word. That's the clue. I'm a string instrument. Double bass. A lot of people get that one right. Louder crescendo. Not laptop drawing. Glad we didn't put any. One person's put laptop drawing. You can use all of these to find out more about playing a musical instrument. Particularly, take a look at the Musica Kirklees website. There's all sorts of ideas on there. And have a look at their YouTube page. Brass instrument, French horn, a few people going with a saxophone still. What does a saxophone have which makes it a woodwind instrument?
Oh.
Does it have which vibrates? Go on, Emily.
The mouthpiece.
It has a mouthpiece, but brass instruments do. There's a piece of wood in that mouthpiece. Anyone remember what it's called? The oboe's got one, the clarinet's got one, the bassoon's got one.
Is it a reed?
Oh, excellent, Kanan, well done. It is a reed. Brass instrument play a low pitch is the tuba. Not bad scores there, not bad at all. Today we're going to listen to that piece we've just heard. I'm going to have one more go at it and get to tell me something about it. Tell me about its dynamics. Tell me about how it's playing. Is it quite staccato? Short notes. Is it presto? Is it moderato? Is it andante? Adagio? What would you say the tempo is? What instruments can you hear? Think of all the things you can tell me about this piece. And get ready to share them. And if you know the name of a piece, tell me the name of a piece. If you know the composer, even better. Starts off quite quiet. What can you hear already? What's the music doing? Recall that movement in its volume, dynamics. Think what you can tell me. Very, very loud. It's in the calling, French horn, with the carpool scale, music, fighting scene. Right, whilst you're listening, I'm going to sort that through to you. lesson in life, children. If you're going to go out to another classroom to fix the computer, don't forget to take the thing powering the internet and leave it here. Don't take it with you, because the entire lesson fails out. Hopefully, it should be back up with us or our viewers, but hopefully, we should be back up. Hopefully, you'll see us in a second. Apologies for that. Should be back up and running again. I'm so pleased that. So let's see what we've got. Tempo Andante, brass loud, exciting, getting loud all the way through, quite forte, sounds like wall, dramatic, fast, French horns, someone's found the title of the piece, Mars, violin, sounds like the beginning of the movie, it does. Scare, low pitch, as in, what's your guitar? I think I did say that's your guitar. It's quite staccato, well done Evie, I'd agree. We're back up again.
Nope, we still have our error message showing.
Send me across. Cut the cattle. So people like joining us, they can refresh their video and we'll be back on again. Okay, hopefully everyone's managed to rejoin us again. We'll try and get through this lesson without any more hiccups, any more distractions. We're going to look today at families of the orchestra. We've looked at the woodwind, we've looked at the brass, we've looked at the string. Who is left? Sienna.
Percussion.
We are going to look at the percussion family today. Percussion. Genuine things you hit. If you hit it, it's usually percussion. It can play rather loud passages, particularly our big, bold drums. And the variety in the timbre, the sound that they produce. Instruments are made of different textures and different materials. So instruments which you hit which are made of metal sound very different from instruments made of wood. There are tuned percussion, which means they can play different notes, and untuned percussion, which means it only plays one note. So if I had a triangle, I can't make it play lots of different notes, can I? But if I had a glockenspiel, I can play a full range of notes. We'll be learning a bit more about it today. Let's join in at the House of Sound. We'll be listening to the same piece we have. Not quite as good, I think it's fair to say.
This music is all about the planet Mars, and it was composed by a man called Gustav Holst.
Ah, but did you know that Mars was also the Roman god of war?
Oh,
I did,
yeah. That's why it makes me think of soldiers marching into battle.
Do you know what it makes me think
Someone
of?
Said that.
What? That we should actually explain how these drums work.
Good idea. Drums have been around for a long, long time, and they were often used in war. A drum has been found by archaeologists in a place called Moravia in Europe, and it turned out to be 8,000 years old.
Whoa! But drums are pretty simple instruments. They're called percussion instruments. And percussion just means one thing hitting another. Thank you. And so to play a drum, all you need to do is hit it. Beautiful, Greg.
Thanks.
As well as the drum, other percussion instruments include the triangle. Thank you. The tambourine. Thank you. And the cymbals.
I'm just going to stop it there because the way he plays cymbals can only be described as wrong. Look how he plays them.
Are you sure?
Yes.
Okay.
Oh. If you ever play cymbals, if you do that, all the air gets trapped inside. If you play them like that, and all the air ricochets, and all the vibrations can ricochet through the air. Bit of my guilty secret, when I used to play in a university orchestra, quite a few years ago now, I used to keep going back because I had something to do, but I didn't play my clarinet anymore. So they asked me if I could play some percussion, and I thought, yeah, just hitting things. Turns out percussion, very, 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 very skilled. And I would spend every time we played, being humiliated by the actual proper percussion players who could make their instrument sound fantastic. And mine sounded like,
Well, it sounded like an out-of-time tambourine. Anyway, let's get back to the video.
That's pretty loud. Drums come in all shapes and sizes, but basically each of them is a hollow body which has a skin over the top. And the skin is stretched very, very tight. When you bang a drum, the skin vibrates. The vibration of the drum makes the air particles inside and around the drum vibrate too, and this forms sound waves. The sound waves travel out in all
Not
directions. And if they reach your ears, that means you'll hear the sound of the drum.
Right, so we have got this drum here. And let's imagine...
Please
this
move your drums a little bit more delicately.
...are the tiny particles that make up air, the air molecules. Okay? And watch what happens when I hit the drum. Thank you.
Whoa! That's good!
That is awesome! That is cool.
Nothing to say there, just two adults hitting some confetti. But you get the idea, don't you? That vibration is really important across all of music. Just watch a little bit more of this video.
And hit the skin of her drum earlier. The middle ear and the inner ear convert those vibrations into signals that our brains interpret as sounds.
Now, excuse me, big drums have a lot of air inside them. And when a drum has a lot of air to vibrate, it makes a low sound. It has what we call a low pitch.
But this little drum has less air inside it, and when you have less air to vibrate, you get a sound with a high pitch.
Nice. But you can also change the sound a drum makes in other ways too. So this drum has a skin which you can make tighter or slacker by turning these handles. So the
What other instruments you looked at which you can make tighter or slacker, Sienna?
Violin.
Violins have tuning pegs on, don't they? That's very similar to a violin.
At the moment, the drum sounds like this.
And if we tighten the skin, it sounds like this. Higher. You can even tighten the skin as you're playing it as well to change the pitch. The other thing that's interesting is that the harder you hit the skin, the larger the vibrations and the louder the sound.
So, lots to learn there. Those, they're still untuned, even where you can change the pitch, you've got to physically move everything around, so it's not like you can just hit it at different parts. Also, where you hit, or as a percussionist would tell you, where you hit the instrument will change the timbre, the texture of the sound. So if you hit it around here, you get quite a sharper sound. Hit it in the middle, which is more, I won't say wetter, it's more plumper, more bassier. Some instruments have different things on them as well, so that they vibrate and rattle and make different noises. We're going to be looking at those as we're going along. There's lots of different instruments, and we're going to be learning about some of these today. Here's some I've picked up from the Encyclopaedia Britannica. There is the bass drum. Bass meaning bass guitar, bassoon, double bass. What does bass mean?
A lower pitch.
A low pitch instrument. So how do I know that's going to be a low pitch just from looking at it? What's the big clue? Emily.
Because it's a big instrument.
It's huge, isn't it? Imagine carrying that. You're carrying that and you hit it, everyone's going to hear it as well because it's massive. Then you've got the timpani. Timpani, you have different sets of timpani, we all play a different note. This timpani is very fancy. It's got a pedal on it and you can use a pedal to change how tight the skin is. What would happen if I tightened the skin? What would happen to the note, Kanan?
Would it become higher?
It would become higher. Excellent. Now, when I used to play the timpani badly, very, very badly, it didn't have this one, I had tuning pegs, so I had to put my ear to it and try and tighten the pegs and get it exactly right. Turned out, doing that in the middle of a piece of music without no one noticing, very hard indeed. So a timpani player will often have different timpani so he can change note quickly. We've got the xylophone, made out of wood. Xylophones made out of wood. And everyone should know xylophone because every time anyone's ever done the alphabet, X always means xylophone for some reason, or X-ray. You notice they're hit by mallets as well. If you hit it with a different mallet, that's going to sound differently. And speak to someone who does percussion. If you're in year six next year, have a word with there's some percussion players in your class. Have a word with them about the different mallets. Here's a gong. Big gongs are called tam-tams. They play nice low notes. If you've been to Cliff House in year five,
You'll know that a gong makes a big gong sound at the start of the film. Gong. And then we've got the snare drum. Now the snare drum has got some tiny beads underneath it. When you hit the snare drum, those beads vibrate and get a very different sound. We've got some other instruments as well. Let's see if you can guess what these are. Up at the top, we've got this instrument. Sometimes comes with little bead, little brass plates around it. What could that be? It's a tambourine. Not always using every piece of music, and sometimes different composers with different instruments. We've seen these already. What instrument do we have here? Hit them like this. What have we got in the classroom, if you remember at home? They are cymbals. One of the words we learn in spelling, because they are not cymbals. That's a homophone. That's C-Y-M is the spelling. This instrument here, the triangular shaped instrument?
Triangle.
They were obviously hexagonal until 1968, where Britain lost a lot of money and had to start making them out of triangles. That's a lie, making it up. We've usually been triangular shaped. Nice instrument to play. Hit it with a beater, you'll see it's got a hook on it. If I was to hold the triangle, that would stop all the vibrations. So I hold it separately so that I'm not stopping those vibrations. Very difficult to play quietly, triangle. What do you think these blocks made out of wood are called? These blocks made out of wood. These blocks made out of wood. Sienna?
Wood blocks.
Yeah, wood blocks. Make a nice, bit like a cuckoo sound. A bit like a woodpecker hitting a tree. I am speaking the sound. These are some Spanish instruments. Probably came around in ancient Greece.
Clarinets.
Not clarinets, very close. Castanets. Using a lot in dancing. And this instrument makes a whipping sound. It's called the whip. Let's listen to some of those in action. We're going to watch part of the one of my favourite pieces. You probably know it. It is the Young Person's Guide to the Orchestra. We're going to listen to the percussion section of this piece. And let's see if you can pick out the instrument being played. Just get my head. There are cellos showing off, double basses showing off.
The brass.
And brass are always showing off. What are these instruments? Trumpets. These ones. Trombones. It's a bass trombone, that one. Woodwind showing off. Right, here we go. Let's listen to some of the instruments from...
Nets, the shining gong, plus some I haven't room to name. But you will hear them all the same.
So we're going to start with the timpani. Can you see the timpani playing different instruments? Can you see how it's rolling? The rolling is... There's the bass drum, that low thud. Can you hear the cymbals as well? There's the cymbal play. Do you see how he played them? Crashing them together. There's the tambourine. There's the triangle. Can you hear it? Really high. Can you hear the snare drum? Really sharp. Here's the wood block. Can you hear that wood sound? There's the xylophone. That's a bloke with a flower for somebody instead of a xylophone. Here's castanets. Can you see the castanet playing? Not playing them up here, it's playing them down on a block of wood. And there's the gong. Here's the whip. Can you see her playing the whip? Tapping it together. Here's all them playing together.
The orchestra. We've taken it apart.
You want to be
be a great percussion player, you need to be really clear with your rhythm. That's really important. Everyone else follows you, getting that rhythm, that pulse right. But you also have to be good at playing different instruments. Because if you're a percussion player, you don't just expert in the triangle. You have to know how to play all of the different instruments. It's a really fantastic and important part of being a musician. So we're nearly at the end. We're just going to listen to a little bit more of this piece and see if we can pick out all the instruments we've done. Then I'm going to do a quick recap, and then I'm going to finish off by playing you something quite modern and quite old at the same time. Let's listen all the way through. Can we pick out the different instruments?
Part. And now we're going to reassemble it. That's not too hard. They all know when to start.
I'm going to stop her from talking a second. She's very lovely. We're going to play something called a fugue. Now, fugue is where everyone plays the same tune and it gradually overlaps. It's a very clever way of writing music. So if you can hear the same tune,
and the conductor helps them out a bit. They're going to play a fugue.
The
piccolo will pipe a theme, and then you'll hear it played by other instruments. Some high, some low. They'll weave their voices into a brocade. And then, to add a further complication, the brass play Purcell's theme. Tunes dance around each other in a final celebration of all the riches of the world of sound.
High instrument on the woodwind, piccolo. Here's the flutes joining in. You can see that flute's made out of wood, that flute's made out of metal. Playing together. Here's Steve's instrument. What do you think it is? It's the oboe. There's my favourite instrument, single reeded, clarinet. Who's going to join in next, do you think? Here they are. Low instruments, double reeded, they are bassoons. High string instruments, what could this one be? Lots of them, loads of them. Violins. Here we go next, slightly bigger, baby. Then violas. A little bit lower, more like the human voice. They are cellos. And they're playing the tune very, very low down on the double basses. What could this instrument be? Have a think at home. It's the harp. Oh, lovely spent, my favourite thing. Go on to brass now. Here we go. There's the French horns. Here come the trumpets. Really sharp and piercing. Here the trombones. And the tuba. And last but not least, the percussion. Here we go. And then here comes the brass to play the original tune. Can we hear that original tune? Can you hear the cymbals? The whole orchestra coming together, playing a magnificent sound. And all the same tune together. Can you hear the drums? Can you hear the strings, the brass, the woodwind? Everyone coming together for a massive crescendo and a brilliant finale. Woo! There's one of the best things you can do. Go and see an orchestra playing something magnificent. It is amazing. Go and see anyone playing something magnificent. Go and see a guitarist playing at a festival. Go and see a band. Go and see a brass band. Go and see a woodwind quartet. Go and see a choir singing. Go and see music. There is nothing better you can do. We have done lots of learning all about instruments. So I want you to tell me, from anything you've done in these lessons about woodwind, flute, percussion, brass, something you've learned, you can share with me, it's coming up on your screens in a second,
Three things you've learned and a question you might have. So three things you've learned and a question you might have. It seems the dogs on here, perhaps you can tell me three things I've missed out. So, three things you've learned should be coming up on your screens in a second. Use the A tool to write. Three things you've learned, one thing you have. A question still about, we'll see if we can answer them. I probably don't know most of the answers, but I'm sure we can find someone who does. What have you learned about music over these online lessons? Something about brass perhaps, something about woodwind, something about the strings. Is it a different instrument? Is it what a reed does? Is it a musical term you've learned? I'll leave reminding everyone to like and subscribe there. Once you've got your ideas, press the done button. We can see what you've come up with. Let's have a bit of music while you're waiting. I've already been done for copyright on YouTube, a bit more can't hurt. Something quite percussion-y. Quite modern as well. Maybe a bit too modern is that, but for now. This would do. Can you add to me three things you've learned, three facts you've learned? And click the green done button when you think you're ready to share something with me. So it could be anything about percussion, anything about woodwind, anything about strings, anything about brass, anything about a musical term you've learned. Here's Grace. Grace learned about new instruments, new things. What new things have you learned? She learned about how a drum vibrates. Fantastic. What else have you learned? Some time to do this and make you get some interesting answers. Have you learnt the name of getting louder? Have you learnt the name of getting softer? Have you learnt what word we use for volume in music? Have you learnt something about trombone? Or French horn. Lots of people in our lesson today. Let's see how Charlie Gibbons is getting along so far. Nothing as yet. So Dolling's learning about the vibrating skin on the drum. Fantastic. And which Mr. Dolling is, Master or Junior? A bit longer to come up with your ideas. Sophie E in 5P. She learnt about the woodwind family. She learnt about Mozart as a piccolo. Is a guitar in an orchestra? What a fantastic question, Sophie E in 5P. Sometimes some more modern composers have used a guitar in an orchestra. So one such example would be the Concerto de Orange Juice, or as I know it, the Concerto of Orange Juice, which uses a guitar. Here's a performance by famous guitarist John Williams, different John Williams from a bloke who does the film music. It's him just tuning up. So yes, here's a piece of music with guitar in it. Oh, Chloe's got some answers for me. You can change the note of drums, you can class cymbals up and down, not straight forward. Mr. Luby's favourite brass instrument isn't the oboe. Mr. Luby's favourite brass instrument is the tenor horn. But very close. How many brass instruments are they? Well, it depends if you are in an orchestra or in a brass band. It's a really good question. Maybe you could go and find that for me, Chloe. Let's look at Ashton's work. Is my favourite piece, Feelings, by Ken Dodd. Nothing on Baston just yet, so we can add to me, please. Evie Young. Music can all sorts of different sounds, instruments can be all sorts of different shapes and sizes, and how drum breaks. How many people play in an orchestra at a time?
modern day orchestras? That's a really good question. It depends. Orchestras have got bigger and bigger over time. And modern day orchestra has... Symphony orchestra may have about 100 players, some orchestras are much smaller. Let's see what else we've got. Good question, Evie, thank you. Harley, what's Harley got for me? He's been learning about different ways to play instruments. You don't have to play symphonies together. You can either read to play a wood instrument, not every wood instrument, but quite a lot of wood instruments. When did the first piece of music play? First piece of music played when the first humans were born. The moment we could make noises and grunt, we started to sing, we started to make a beat with the drum. Music's been around probably longer than anything else. Lucas in 3T, hello Lucas. Right. What are we... Don't quite follow that one, Lucas. If you can have a look at that question for me. Answer. When will we learn about the Woodwind family? Oh, and we've looked at the Woodwind family. Go back and look at Mr. Lubick Noah Sports channel. You'll see all about the Woodwind family there. But if you've forgotten, you can always go on the BBC Bite Size website and BBC Make Bring the Noise. It's got some great ideas, along with the Music of Kirk Lee's channel. Some wonderful music instruments is on there. Lucy's been learning about drums. Largo means slow. What is Mr. Lubick's favourite instrument? My favourite instrument is the clarinet. Daisy, hi Daisy. Learn that you don't have to bass symbols together, you slide them. There's other ways to play them as well, but I'm not very good to play. I was largo being slow. I've learned that you can tie symbols together in the drum. When did people start using the term percussion or brass? That is a brilliant question. You know what, I don't know the answer to that one, Daisy. That is an absolutely brilliant question. Where do these terms come from? Fantastic question. I have no idea. Go and find out for me. Holly. Holly B. Drum vibrates, piccolo is higher than oboe. How many pieces of Benjamin Britten conducted? Oh, it's a great question, brilliant question. Benjamin Britten was a composer in the early 20th century. Did some wonderful pieces, as well as a piece we've heard. He did an opera called Peter Grimes. There's lots of other pieces as well. Best place to go is look at the Britten Pairs Foundation. They've got all the information on Benjamin Britten and his partner, somebody Pairs, whose name I forget, I'm afraid. Molly. Drums vibrate. How many woodwinds are there? Your main wood instruments are the oboe, the flute, the piccolo, the cor anglais, the clarinet, the bass clarinet, the bassoon, the contra bassoon, and the, have I said the flute?
No.
And the flute. They're your main instruments in an orchestra. There's lots of other wood instruments. Anything you can blow down, which isn't brass, is usually woodwind. Recorder, for example, is one of my favourite wood instruments. Mrs. Cooper. Largo means slow, presto means fast, flutes can be made of utter. How long do musicians train for? It's a brilliant question. You want to be a good musician, at your age, if you want to play an instrument, you should be playing for 10 minutes every day. Not a lot, is it? The best musicians will probably learn for about 10,000 hours to become an orchestra musician. But 10 minutes a day is the right place to start. Hassan. Oboe's very high pitched. It can do some lower notes, but it's not got a bigger range as some of the pieces. Violins are very small, crescendo is getting louder. How do you know it's so high pitched? That's a very great question. It's to do with how it's played with a reed and how small it is compared to other instruments. So also the musician can play higher pitches by changing the keys to play higher readings there. Emily. A brass family, the trombone and the French horn, and the wooden family. Is there a metal flute? Yeah, there's lots of metal flutes. Many flutes today are made out of metal. Some very occasionally made out of plastic. I've got somewhere on my desk. Here somewhere I've got a fife, which is a bit like a plastic flute. Goodness knows where it actually is. It's somewhere on my desk, but my chances of finding it after lockdown are slim to none, I think. I've got a bat on. I've got some dice. I've got half a musical instrument in here. I've got some pens, but I cannot find my fife for love nor money. I have found that in my thing I was looking for a couple of days ago. I wish I found it a couple of days ago. Lost it again now. Oops, has it come off the screen? Come back on. Come back
couple of moments to get any ideas down. You finished. Lots of people working hard. Lily, let's take a look at Lily's work. Great, thanks for how many orchestras you've some fantastic orchestras you've anywhere where people to come together, people play. There's some really good professional orchestras. Most major cities have a professional orchestra. Closest to us is the BBC Philharmonic, for example. And there's also the Manchester... The Manchester and Salford Orchestra Corps. It's completely gone out of my head. Oh dear, it's completely gone. There's also Leeds Opera North is based in Leeds, which is an orchestra which specialises in opera. There's lots of other orchestras. The great thing is, orchestras don't stay where they are, they go around to different places. You don't have to go where they are, they'll come to you. All in for them. First instrument, probably a drum, we don't know for certain. Molly. Woodwinds, oh, we've answered that one, haven't we? Not too sure, we've gone for the main ones. What is the biggest orchestra ever? It's a great question. A brilliant question. It's probably going to be... I saw a great video recently and about 1,000 drummers all playing together, but I don't know the answer to that question. Great question, though, Poppy. Mr. Dolling, here we go. I don't know if it's Master Dolling or Dolling. Why does the piano belong to more than one family? What a great question. Can anyone help us explain that one? Why does the piano belong to more than one family? Sienna.
Because when you hit it, the strings inside that make it vibrate.
So hitting it would make it which family?
Percussion.
And the strings would make it?
Strings.
Excellent question, yeah. I hope that helps, Mr. Dolling. Pizzicato means plucked and arco means with a bow. Mars has 5 beats in a bar. Did you hear that? Yeah, it's not in a standard 4 beat. Very unusual. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. 1, 2, da, da, ba, ba, ba. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. Very unusual. Uses triplets in groups of 3. Very well done. Very well listened, Mr. Dolling there. Harry. The oboe sounds like a duck. Is there now? Is there anything which sounds like a pig? I don't know. You know what? Someone should invent one. If there isn't one. I love that, thank you. Harry's favourite instrument is the trombone. If you want to learn the trombone, Harry, have a word with Mr. Dolling. You don't need to learn a brass one, you could learn a plastic trombone. They're really good and really fun. Lucas, have we looked at Lucas's? I think we have, haven't we? Holly C, we looked at Holly C's, we looked at Holly B's, remember? Who created the orchestra? Great question. I think it might have been... Great question. I'm going to say Bach, but I don't want to go about that one. Different ways to describe music, really clear answer there. Drums have a hollow body, skin top and vibrates from sound waves. Vibrates to form sound waves. Even brass and instrument family, including French horn, trumpets, trombones and a tuba. Great responses. Some really, 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 really good work there. Going to finish with one little thing. I'm going to stop Rodrigo going on. Thank you, mate. Lovely, but we've had enough. I'm going to listen to a couple of pieces of music. I want you to tell me what's similar in all of them, what's different. I'm going to start with this piece. This is Mr. Luby's least favourite piece of music of all time. It's incredibly popular by the people. It's by Pachelbel. It's a canon, which means everyone follows each other. It's in D major. Quite nice, isn't it? Fortunately, I've heard it about 1,000 times now. Even more than I heard the Year 6 Leader song. I just want to listen to it a bit longer. Skip on a bit. Okay, I'm going to play something completely different now. This is by Maroon 5. It's called Memories. What's similar and what's different? Ba 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 ba. Ba 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 Here's another piece. This is from a band called Farm. Listen to those bottom notes. Da 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 So, between those pieces, what's similar and what's different?
Have a go.
I'll play you a bit more of one of them. I'm going to play you a little bit more of the Packer Bell. Go west, it is peaceful day. Go west. Here's to the piece of fear. Here's to the piece of memory. Memories that are you. So they're both happy at the same bass line. Oh, they're using a circle of fifth. They are using a circle of fifth. Yeah, they are. We'll talk about that another day. They are using a circle of fifth. They are using the same pattern. Let's just listen to that bass line right at the start of the piece. They skipped it out on purpose. That's the same in every piece, that bass line. One has lyrics, one doesn't. Melodies of a lower pitch, rather than how it does, yeah. It's lower. One has words, different speeds, yeah, excellent. We have the same bass, I'm going to put that one over here, Lily. Same melody and the same chords. The chords are really important there, yeah. First one's nice and calm, I'm going to put that one over here. All the same bass line, same kind of background, yeah, I think you've got the idea. Repeated pattern, the same pattern. Amelie's also noticed, like Mr. Dolin now, that he's got a circle in. That's got a circle in me. Well done. Well done, Amelie. To move on blocks, but never mind. Maybe in 5 years' words? Yeah. I think the message there is if you're listening music, you can hear all sorts. You can hear all sorts of patterns. You can be a really good detective. Maroon 5 have got away with literally nicking that piece because it's so old it's out of copyright. We can't do what we think is in copyright. But have a listen, there's all sorts of melodies you can hear in different pieces of music which have been, I'm not going to say stolen, because they've been reimagined. Maroon 5 haven't just copied a recording and put it out again. They've made it their own, they've made it, well, I won't say special because that's a truly awful song for me. But I can see you disagreeing here. That's absolutely brilliant, and glad you disagree. Lots of people love that song, I'm just not one of them. Mainly because I don't like Packer Bell's Canon, which is why I don't like that. But lots of the same rhythm, the same chords. We'll do another lesson, if we ever get locked down again. The next lesson I'll be doing is about how the same four chords, the same bass line, has been used in nearly every piece of music which has ever been popular. In fact, you'll probably find out more about it. If you listen to a piece called the midnight train going, who sang that, going anywhere, just a smiley girl. What's that piece called now? Don't Stop Believing by Journey. Listen to that piece, that's it. You'll hear that piece all over the shop. Anyway, I really enjoyed these music lessons. Thank you so much for your time. Thank you so much for your journey. Don't forget, the best thing you can ever do is play a musical instrument, and there's lots of ways to do that even during lockdown. Have a word with your parents if it's something for you. 10 minutes a day can make them to a superstar. I don't play in an orchestra. I don't make any money from playing music, and I absolutely love it. I play for me, and I play to share music and be part of something with other people. It's one of the greatest things you can do. And if you don't want to play a musical instrument, the next greatest thing is listening and enjoying music. Go away, listen to as many different things as you can. Anything from this year all the way back to the earliest piece of music. There's something in there for everyone. Thank you ever so much for your time. We will see you another time. Don't forget to like and subscribe. And we'll see you for our final lesson for Years 2 and 3 tomorrow with Mrs. Shane. Bye-bye.
Bye.
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 Bye.